That would have a devastating impact on Paterson.
Mayor Andre Sayegh says his city relies heavily on state transitional aid. Paterson received $33 million last year. This year they hope for $26 million. But Governor Murphy's frozen most of the transitional aid to municipalities in the new state budget. It's the biggest chunk of $235 million in spending items the governor's locked up in reserve, a list Treasury unveiled today with 64 items, including aid for colleges, hospitals, parks, and prisons.
The overwhelming amount of the up to 235 are programs we like.
When he signed the $38.7 billion state budget, Governor Murphy indicated he couldn't justify authorizing those expenditures because he believed the legislature overestimated its revenue projections by $200 million, and lawmakers had refused to raise more revenue by passing his millionaire's tax.
I want to build a basketball hoop in every driveway in the state, but I gotta, at the end of the day, the buck stops with me. I've got to certify these revenues. I've got to make sure that we are within our means.
The $104.8 million in transitional aid tops Murphy's list of $235 million in frozen spending items. It includes millions for colleges like Montclair State, Stockton University, and Cooper Medical School, grants for a South Jersey cancer program, money for Essex County jail programs, traffic studies, arts, and agriculture. Locking up spending items pending required revenue isn't a new budget trick. Governor Christie did it in 2016. And some $27 million worth of frozen programs are tied to Murphy's nemesis and longtime friend of Senate President Steve Sweeney, South Jersey power broker George Norcross.
There's certainly political undercurrents here, though I think the driving force would just be the financial realities and the governor having this concern about some of the savings and revenue items that were in the legislative budget. At the end of the day, it's the governor who has that constitutional authority to certify revenues. And Murphy is tying these reserve items to maintaining the surplus.
Sweeney, who stands by the legislature's revenue estimates, today said in a scathing statement, the governor's action putting a so-called freeze on items cherry-picked from the budget is a shameless act of political retribution that's both petty and vindictive. It's Bridgegate on steroids that punishes those who disagree. This is an abuse of gubernatorial power that victimizes some of the neediest and most vulnerable people in New Jersey. The spending freeze is certainly problematic for mayors in cities like Atlantic City, Camden, and Paterson, who depend on transitional aid to balance their budgets.
Yeah, I mean, there's the potential for layoffs. I mean, you're looking at police, fire, public works, potentially. So we're going to fight to avert that at all costs.
First of all, why are they even on this list? They're already been determined to be literally the most needy municipalities in the state. They need this money to make their cash flow. The state has determined that.
The question now, assuming revenues do increase, when and how might spending be restored?
We normally don't receive our award until later in the year. And we will have time to lobby, and we will have advocates.
How long will the freeze last? The governor's indicated he wants proof the revenues are there before he authorizes any spending. In Paterson, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJTV News.